వక్రతుండ మహాకాయ సూర్యకోటి సమప్రభ నిర్విఘ్నం కురు మే దేవ సర్వకార్యేషు సర్వదా సరస్వతి నమస్తుభ్యం వరదే కామరూపిణి విద్యారంభం కరిష్యామి సిద్ధిర్ భవతు మే సదా. గురవే సర్వలోకానాం విషయే భవరోగిణాం నిధయే సర్వవిద్యానాం దక్షిణామూర్తయే నమః. ఈశ్వరో గురురాత్మేతి మూర్తి భేద విభాగినే వ్యోమవత్ వ్యాప్త దేహాయ దక్షిణామూర్తయే నమః. సదాశివ సమారంభాం శంకరాచార్య మధ్యమాం అస్మదాచార్య పర్యంతాం వందే గురు పరంపరాం. శృతి స్మృతి పురాణానాం ఆలయం కరుణాలయం నమామి భగవత్పాదం శంకరం లోక శంకరం. సాక్షాత్ కృతం దయానందం పరమార్థ స్వరూపిణం తత్వజ్ఞాన ప్రశాస్తారం ప్రణతోస్మి పరం పదం. ఓం సహనావవతు సహనౌ భునక్తు సహ వీర్యం కరవావహై తేజస్వినావధీతమస్తు మా విద్విషావహై. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతి. ఓం నమో భగవతే వైవస్వతాయ మృత్యవే బ్రహ్మ విద్యాచార్యాయ నచికేతసే చ. We are studying Kathopanishad, Prathamadhyaya, Dvitiya Valli. First chapter, second section of the Kathopanishad. The teacher of the Kathopanishad, Yamadhammaraja, he begins his teaching of Brahma Vidya with a beautiful introduction from this section, Dvitiya Valli onwards. He introduces Vedanta using the words Shreyas and praises Shreyas in comparison to Prayas in the first mantra. Just to give you a recap of what we have seen so far, where we left before the break. So the first mantra is an introduction. The first mantra as well as the second mantra is the introduction to the teaching. Introduction to Vedanta is given by Yamadhammaraja using the words Shreyas. The second mantra, Yamadhammaraja, he praises the one who chooses prayers, Shreyas, who chooses Shreyas, who chooses Shreyas, a Viveki chooses Shreyas, and like a swan, like a Hamsapakshi, the Viveki, the Dhiraha, Shreyasaha, Preyaha, Preyasaha, Shreyaha, Abhivrinite. He chooses Shreyas compared to Preyas. Preyasaha, Shreyaha, Abhivrinite. That is the second mantra. Second mantra is a praise of the student, Brahma Vidya student, who chooses Shreyas in comparison to Prayas. The third mantra, Madhama Raja, he praises the student Nachiketas. He praises the student Nachiketa for he completely disregarded the offerings of Yamadharma Raja, who attempted to tempt Nachiketa by various offerings. And therefore, Yamadharma Raja told Pralobhyamanaha api tvam Pralobhyamanaha api tvam atyasakshi. Though tempted, but you completely disregarded, rejected the prayers. So it's a praise of the student by the teacher himself. And in the next mantra, that is a fourth mantra, which is a very important mantra. Why it is important? Because through this mantra, what you see in the screen, Duravete Viparite Vishochi, the fourth mantra, through this mantra, Bhagavad Pada, it dismisses Jnana Karma Samuchaya. The combination of Jnana and Karma for Moksha, that is dismissed by Bhagavad Pada, about which we recently discussed. We recently discussed in the Bhagavad Gita class, and we will be discussing in the other Gita classes also. The topic will be discussed. So here, Vidya and Avidya, they are Duram Viparite. Ete Duram Viparite. Ete refers to Vidya and Avidya. Vidya, Vidye. Ete Duram Viparite. Ete Vishuchyau. This Vidya and Avidya, they are different. They are different in terms of their nature as well as the phalam, the results. Both in terms of Subhava and as well as Pala. Subhavataha, Palataha api. Ete Viparite Vishuchyau. This Vidya and Avidya, that is Jnana and Karma, both are totally different. Jnanam is called Vidya and Karma is called Avidya. Karma or Upasana is called Avidya. Preyo Vishaya Avidya, because prayers involves karma, action. And Shreyo Vishaya Vidya, because Shreyas involves Jnanam, knowing, understanding. Aparamchet Praptavyam, Paramchet Gatavyam. That is the rule. So therefore, Shreyas is something which to be known. It is Param. Therefore, Gnatavyam. Hope you remember all the mantras, what we have seen in the previous classes. And in the fifth mantra, Yamadharma Raja, the Upanishad, he praises the Shreyurti by criticizing the ignorant people. By criticizing the ignorant people, praises the Shreyurti, the seekers after moksha. And in the sixth mantra, Sixth mantra also does the same thing. Sixth mantra also does the same thing. Those for whom there is nothing other than this tangible world, for them, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. That is guaranteed. Therefore, Yamadharma Raja says, punaha punaha me vasham apadyate. They again and again they come back, come to my grip. Because they are ignorant people. They are mudaha. They don't believe in paraloka. Ayam lokaha. Ayam lokaha asti, paralokaha nasti iti. Yahamani saha punaha punaha me vasham apadyate. Because for them, what they perceive through the senses, for them, the tangible world alone is real. They don't believe the other loka. They don't believe. It means they don't believe what the Shastram says. Therefore, they come under my grip again and again, says Yamadharma Raja. They are ignorant people. Mudaha. And in the seventh mantra, which we saw, with the Bhashyam, all the mantras we saw with the Vashyam, and the seventh mantra, Upanishad glorifies Atma Vidya by glorifying the teacher, by glorifying the student, as well as the Vidya, the knowledge. How does it glorify? Glorifies by saying that the knower of Atma is rare. Therefore, Ascharya. And to be taught by such people, the jnanis, is also rare. That is also another ascharyam. It's a wonder. Because of rarity, it is a wonder. And even when taught, understanding is rare. Why? Because the student has to be qualified, has to be prepared. That is also a rarity. Therefore, that is also a wonder. So it glorifies. By saying wonder, everything is wonder, it glorifies the teacher, the student, as well as the vidya. Then we have to see the eighth mantra. We saw in the last class, we read the mantra, but we have not seen the Bhashyam, but we will see the mantra. We will see the mantra as well as the meaning of the individual words of the mantra. So you can repeat after me. Na nare na vare na prokta heshaha.
Ananya
prokte gatiratranasti. Aniyan yatarkyam anu pramanat.
Aniyan yatarkyam anu pramanat.
Aniyan hi atarkyam anu pramanat. Okay. First we will see the general meaning, then we can see the individual words and the Vashyam. This mantra, it highlights the importance of the teacher, Acharya. The teacher of the Brahma Vidya is glorified. Acharya Stuti. Acharya Stuti. First Shishya Stuti, then Vidya Stuti, then Acharya Stuti. Atma is speculated in different ways by the people who have no understanding of what Atma is. Either they have no understanding or they misunderstand Atma. That is why there are so many theories about Atma. Atma being inaccessible to mere reasoning, mere logical reasoning, therefore, it is inscrutable for the incompetent people. That is why Mundaka Upanishad it mentions that the teacher of Atma should be Yashrutriya Brahmanishta. Samitkanagi Shrutriyam Brahmanishtam. It says that with the Samit near hand, go to Yashrutriya Brahmanishta to gain the knowledge. So the teacher should be a Yashrutriya as well as a Brahmanishta. Brahmanishta means Brahmani Nishta Yashante. That is, those who are Nishta. Those who are Nishta in Brahma. That is, the one who looks upon himself as Brahma, not separate from Brahma, not as a Jiva. He looks upon himself as Brahma. He has a clear vision of Aham Brahma Asmi, Jagat Karanam Brahma Aham Asmi. That Jnanam is there for whom is Brahmanishta. Is established in that Jnanam. At any point of time in life, is not away from this Jnanam. Though his involvement is there in the Vyavahara life, but the Jnanam is in intact. His identification is only with Brahma. Though he is active in the Vyavaharika life also. So such persons are called Brahmanishta. Jadabharata is a Brahmanishta. Janaka Raja is also Brahmanishta. Shuka is Brahmanishta. Therefore, they're all great and very known people for Nishta in Brahma. But it is difficult to identify Brahmanishtas. It is difficult to identify them. We cannot say who has Nishta in Brahma. Shastram says Janaka and gives those names. They are all Jnani Brahmanishta. Therefore, we know them. Otherwise, it is difficult to identify. How can we know who is Brahmanishta and how can we learn or gain Jnanam from them? We don't have any yardstick to measure the status of Brahmanishta. If that is so, then how to find acharyas? How to find an acharya for learning Atmavidya? For that, Shastram gives a provision. You cannot identify Brahmanishta. To identify a Brahmanishta, you should be a Brahmanishta. If you are a Brahmanishta, then you don't have to find a Brahmanishta. Therefore, Shastra says, since you cannot identify a Brahmanishta, but you can identify a Shrotriya. Who is a Shrotriya? A Shrotriya is one who has the expertise in handling the words of the Shastra. Shrotriya has the key to unlock the hidden meaning of the words of the Shastra. He has a knowledge of the methodology of unfolding the meaning of the words of the Shastra, the teaching of the Shastra. The methodology, what he adopts, it's not that he invented something new. No, it is traditional. The presentation of the Shrotriya may vary from a person to person, but the methodology is traditional. Because it is a traditional methodology, therefore, he must have learned from his guru. So he has a guru. A Shrotriya definitely must have a guru. Because he studied under a guru, therefore, he would have heard Shastram from his guru. Therefore, he is called a Shrotriya. Shrotriya means he has learned the Shastram traditionally from the mouth of a teacher. Therefore, he must be knowledgeable. He must be knowledgeable in handling the words of the Shastram. So therefore, every Shrotriya Acharya must have been a disciple of a guru. Therefore, he can identify the Shrotriya by the way he teaches, by the communication. So, Shastra says, If you don't find a Brahmanishta, you can go to a Shrotriya. A person may be a mere Shrotriya, Kevala Shrotriya, not a Brahmanishta, but still you can learn from such a Shrotriya. Because Brahmanishtas are difficult to find, difficult to identify, Shastram says you can learn from the Shrotriya. Because he has the expertise, the methodology in handling the Pramanam. Therefore, Shrotriya is recommended by the Shastra. A Shrotriya may not be a Uttama Guru. A Shrotriya, he may not be a Uttama Guru. He may be a Madhyama Guru. But since it is difficult to identify or get a Brahmanishta who is a Uttama Guru, it is better to have a Shrotriya as a Guru. Still, you will gain Jnanam. Because a Shrotriya has the knowledge of various prakriyas, methodologies like Adhyaropa, Apavada Prakriya, etc. Therefore, he will not confuse the students. So, his teaching will be clear. There will be clarity in the teaching. He may be a Kevala Shrotriya, but a Kevala Shrotriya is better than a Kevala Brahmanishta. A person may be a Brahmanishta even by birth. By birth, a person may be a Brahmanishta. He may be a born Jnani, but he doesn't have the communication, the know-how of presenting the teaching of the Shastra traditionally. Asampradaya Vita. He may be the best person, a great Jnani, but he cannot be the great Guru. Therefore, if a Kevala Shrotriya is a avara guru meaning incompetent teacher, Kevala Brahmanishta also is an incompetent teacher only. A Kevala Shrotriya, if he is avara guru, then Kevala Brahmanishta is also a avara guru, because a Kevala Brahmanishta doesn't have the know-how, the technique of presenting the teaching of the Shastra. Then who is a competent teacher? The one who is a Shrotriya as well as a Brahmanishta. If you get such a teacher, then definitely you must have done some punyam. But if you don't get such a person as Guru, if you at least get a mere Shrotriya, Kevala Shrotriya, it is better than Kevala Brahmanishta. And in Kathopanishad, the Shrotriya Brahmanishta Guru, the one who is a Shrotriya as well as a Brahmanishta, is called Ananya Guruhu. He is called Ananya Guruhu, Uttama Guruhu. When such a person teaches the Shastram, the knowledge will definitely take place. And here, Nachiketa, he got Yamadharma Raja as his Guru, who is a Uttama Guru, Ananya Guru. Yamadharma Raja is a Shrotriya as well as a Brahmanishta. That is why Nachiketa did not want to miss the opportunity. It is a Durlabha opportunity, and Nachiketa utilized that. So now let us see the Anvaya of the Mantra. Na Narena Avarena. Narena Avarena. It is there. It is Narena Avarena. Proktaha Yeshaha Suvignyayaha Bhagudha Chintyamanaha Ananya Prokte Agatihi Argatihi. You will see this. Ananya Prokte Agatihi. It can be Agatihi or it can be Gatihi. Both possibilities are there when you split this. Ananya Prokte Agatihi Atra Nasti Aniyan Hi Atarkyam Anupramanat. So here Narena Avarena Avarena Narena Proktaha Yeshaha Nasvignyeyaha Bhavati. Narena, Nara is human being. Avarena means incompetent. Avarena narena. It is in Tritya Vibhakti. Avarena narena proktaha taught. Revealed. What is revealed? Yeshaha. Yeshaha refers to Atma. So, avarena narena by an incompetent teacher, by an avaraguru, it could be a madhyama guru, you can take it as a madhyama guru, when, or shrotriya, kevala shrotriya, when taught by an avaraguru, proktaha yeshaha, we need not take it as a kevala shrotriya. Shrotriya is better than kevala brahmanishta. Therefore, we can just take it as a avaraguru means incompetent teacher. A kevala shrutriya is better. So therefore, we can take narena avarena as an incompetent teacher. Just translation can be incompetent teacher. When taught by an incompetent teacher, when revealed by the incompetent teacher, narena avarena narena proktaha yesha atma, this atma, when taught, when revealed by the incompetent teacher, what is that? Nasvigyeyaha. It is not easily comprehensible, understandable when taught by an incompetent teacher. Why? Bhagudha chintyamanaha. Bhagudha. Bhagudha means in many ways. Chintyamanaha. Chintyamanaha means speculated. It is imagined. Imagined to be, Atma is imagined differently by different people. And that when it is revealed by an incompetent person, then it cannot be understood easily. Nasvignyayaha. Sushtu. Visheshena. Nyayaha. It is not available for easy comprehension. Atma is speculated in many ways. And taking Atma to be an akarta, Abhakta has one view among many views, will not give you a dhrida jnanam. There are so many views about Atma, and Atma is also considered to be akarta, abhokta, as one view among many views. That will not give a nischaya jnanam. Because Atma is akarta, Atma is abhokta. That is also possible. If somebody says, then that will not give you a dhrida jnana. This is also satyam, that is also satyam. That is, that accommodation is not acceptable. When it comes to the satyam, the reality, there is no accommodation. It is categorical. So, atma, akarta, atma, abhokta, it is not one of the view. It is the view. Therefore, for people who imagine Atma to be in different ways, Atma cannot be comprehended. Atma cannot be comprehended with such various speculations. There should be firm knowledge with reference to Atma. Advaita Atma is not one among many visions, many views. It is a vision. It is a vision of the Shastram. It is the truth. It is a Satyam. It is not a speculation. Therefore, Ananya Prokte Atra Agatihi Na Asti. The third line of the mantra, Ananya Prokte Atra Agatihi Na Asti. Here the word Ananya Prokte. Ananya Prokta can be interpreted in two ways. The word ananya, ananya is a nice word. Ananya can mean a shrotriya brahmanishta. Ananya prokte, taught by a ananya, ananya guru. It means revealed by, atma revealed by a shrotriya brahmanishta acharya. Ananya prokte. He is called Ananya Acharya. Na Anyaha Vidyate Yasya. There is nothing other than Brahma for him. He is called Ananya. There is nothing other than himself for him. He himself to be Brahman, therefore there is nothing other than Brahma. Anyaha na vidyate yasya. There is nothing other than himself. He is identified with Brahma. Therefore, everything is, what is here is Brahma. Brahma only. So, therefore, he looks upon himself as Brahma, na anyaha, not as any other being, not as a jiva. Therefore, ananya prokta, even taught by such people. So, ananya proktaha means ananya guruhu, uttama guru, ityartaha. This is one meaning. Another possible meaning is, ananya can mean na anya, not other, it means na dvaitam, advaitam. Ananya can also mean advaitam, that which is non-dual. What is non-dual? Atma. Advaita atma, advaita brahma. When advaita brahmatma is a satyam, and when it is taught, then where is the second thing to get confused? To get confused, there is no second thing to the Advaita Atma. What is there is only Brahma, Advaita Brahma. Therefore, there is no second thing, and therefore there is no confusion. Dvaitam only creates fear. Dvaitam only creates confusion. And there is, when the Satyam, when the truth is Advaita, then where is the second thing? So, Dvaitam is swallowed by the teaching. There is Dvaitam when it comes to the empirical world. Experiential Dvaitam is negated by the Paramarthika Advaita Atma. When we say Advaitam, because we experience Dvaitam in the Vyavaharika, in the empirical world, because we experience Dvaitam, it need not be Satyam. This experiential Dvaitam is negated. It is swallowed by the Paramarthika Advaita Atma. From the absolute standpoint, what is there is only Advaita Atma. So, Ananya Prokte can mean Advaita Atma Prokte. When this Advaita Atma is taught, that meaning also we can take. So, two meanings possible. So, therefore, Ananya Prokte Agatihi, as I said before here, Agatihi, by applying the Sanskrita Sandhi rule, Ananya Prokte Gatihi, we can split, or Ananya Prokte Agatihi also, we can split. Taking that to be a Purva Rupa Sandhi, we can split that way also. So both ways we can split, therefore, Agatihi will be one possibility, Gatihi will be another possibility, applying the Sandhi Niyama. So, Ananya Prokte Agatihi Atra Nasti, that is one possibility. Ananya Prokte Gatihi Atra Nasti, that is another possibility. Whatever meaning we take, it means that when Atma is revealed by the Uttama Guru, there cannot be any misunderstanding about Atma. Gatihi also, we will see. Bhagavad Pada gives many meanings for the word Gatihi. We can take it as a Gatihi, we can take it as a Avagatihi, Agatihi. And Gatihi has got many meanings. Bhagavad Pada has given various meanings for the word Gatihi. We will see when we read the Bhashyam. If we take the word to be a Gatihi, let us take it as a Gatihi now. If we take it as a Gatihi, Gatihi can mean doubtful understanding. Samshaya jnanam. Gatihi can mean samshaya jnanam. That is one possibility. If you take that meaning, then the sentence will be Gatihi atra nasti ananya prokte. When taught by the competent guru, Advaita guru, Uttama guru, then there will not be samshaya jnanam. There will not be confusion. There will not be doubtful understanding of Atma. Therefore, Gatihi Atranasi. This is one meaning. If you take the word as Agatihi, Agatihi means non-understanding. Non-understanding. So agatighi atranasti. Ananya prokte agatighi atranasti. When taught by the best acharya, there will not be non-understanding. Double negative. There will not be non-understanding. It means what? There will be understanding. Therefore, what this line, what this mantra says is, only a competent teacher can teach. Why? Why a competent teacher only can reveal Atma? Because Aniyan hi atarkyam anupramanat. The hetu is given. The cause is, the reason is given. Atarkyam yeshaha anupramanat aniyan bhavati. Because Atma is aniyan. Aniyan is subtler. Subtler, what is subtler here? How it is measured? Anupramanat. Anupramana. Anu is atom. Pramana is the measure, the size of the atom. Since Atma is of the size of the atom, size of the atom means, does it really mean Atma is equal to the size of the atom? No. Anupramanat means it is subtler. That is pointed out by the word aniyan. Anupramanat aniyan. It is subtle, very subtle. Like the size of the atom. Atom is given to just to give you an idea. Like an atom, it is subtle. Anupramanat. Like the measure of the size of an atom, Atma is subtle. So it means is Atma is so small, smaller than the atom? No. Atma means all pervading. It is difficult for comprehension. That is what subtlety means. Subtlety not in terms of size. Subtlety not in terms of size, not in terms of form. It is in terms of understanding. It is subtle. So, anupramanat, aniyan, it is subtler. Atma is subtle for understanding. It's a subtle matter. Subtle, not matter means not, it is subtle subject matter. Matter means not liquid, gas, solid. No, that is not the matter. Subtle subject matter. Subject matter being subtle, subject matter being Atma, and that being subtle, therefore, na, it is atarkyam. Therefore, it is atarkyam, na tarkyam. Na tarkya yogyaha. It is not available for tarka. Tarka is logical reasoning. Tarka is for your logic. It is not available for your logic. Atma being very subtle. Subtle for understanding. Subtlety in terms of understanding. Therefore, it is not available for tarka, not available for logic. Atma cannot be known by the application of your logical reasoning. Support of logical reasoning is required, but it cannot establish. Logical reasoning cannot establish, cannot prove Atma. So the reasoning, therefore, the reasoning has no role. Reasoning can support, but it cannot prove Atma, it cannot disprove Atma also. Neither logical reasoning, tarka, can prove Atma, it cannot disprove also. We can take the support of the logic, but it cannot be a pramana, it cannot prove Atma. Therefore, when we say that, we have to understand that the reasoning based on the data collected by the sense organs will not be helpful in understanding Atma. But a reasoning based on Shastram, Shastra Pramanam, it can help in revealing the Advaita Atma. The reasoning should be based on the Shastram. Shruti Matas Tarkonu Sandhiyatam in Sadhana Panchakam Bhagavad Pada says, Shruti Matas Tarkonu Sandhiyatam. You apply your logical reasoning based on the Shastra. You have to apply the reasoning in line with the teaching of the Shastra. So logic can be a support. So without Shastra Pramanam, only by logical reasoning, If you say, if you want to establish Atma, then you cannot do it. You cannot establish Advaita Atma. Vyasacharya in Brahma Sutra, he says, one can never use logic independently to understand Atma. You can use the logic as a support, but Shastram is the Pramana. Not otherwise. You cannot give first place to logic and second place to Shastram. Logic-based Shastram will not work. The logic has to be in line with the teaching of the Shastram. Shuti Mata Tarka alone can help in revealing the Atma. So this is what the meaning of this mantra is. Now we will read the Vashya. You can see this in the screen, the Vashya. You can repeat after me. Nahi narena.
Nahi narena.
Manushyena avarena.
Manushyena avarena.
Proktaha.
Proktaha.
Avarena hinena.
Avarena hinena.
Prakrita buddhina.
Prakrita buddhina.
Iti etad uktaha.
Iti etad uktaha.
Iti etad uktaha is there. I am splitting and splitting that. Iti etad uktaha. Eshaha. Yeah. Eshaha atma.
Eshaha atma.
Yam tvam mam prachasi.
Yam tvam mam prachasi.
Okay, we will see this. This line. Nahi narena manushyena. Narena is equal to manushyena. Bhagavad Pada gives what nara is. Nara is manushya. Narena manushyena avarena proktaha. And avarena, the meaning is given. Narena, the avarena, heenena, prakrita buddhina, iti etat uktaha yeshaha atma yam tvam mam prichasi. So, Narena. Narena is Manushyena. Narena, Manushyena. And who is that Manushya? Who is that person? Avarena. Avarena is incompetent. Heenena. Heena is inferior. So inferior or incompetent. So, by the person who is incompetent. By the teacher who is incompetent. And is prakrita buddhina. Prakrita buddhi. Prakrita buddhi. Prakrita buddhi is what? Prakrita is not samskrita, not refined. So it is unrefined. Unrefined buddhi. Undefined buddhi means the one who has the identification with the body, mind, sense complex. Dehatma buddhina ityartaha. We can take the meaning as prakrita buddhi means dehatma buddhi. One who has the natural notion of this identification with the body, mind, sense complex. So dehatma buddhina, prakrita buddhina is the teacher. If he is a teacher, he is a nara, he is a avarena, narena, proktaha, taught. What is taught? Atma. Iti etat uttaha. Eshaha atma. This atma talked about by that person. Iti etat. Then this atma that is talked about cannot be na narena. So here atma cannot be clearly understood. That comes in the next line. Nahi narena avarena proktaha avarena heenena prakrita buddhina iti etat uktaha yeshaha atma yam tvam mam prichasi. Midramaraja says yeshaha atma, that atma yam tvam mam prichasi, which you asked me, that Atma, when taught by the Avara Guru, Avarena Manushyena, Prakrita Buddhina, it is Na. Na means Na Suvijnyeha. That comes the next line. Na Suvijnyeha, Na Jnatam Shakyaha. When taught by such people, it is not possible to understand. We can read the next line. Nahi Sushtu.
Nahi Sushtu.
Nahi Sushtu. Samyak Vijnyeha. Vignatum Shakyaha. So this we have to connect with the previous line. When taught by such person, our Prakrita Buddhina, Avarena Manushyena, Proktaha Esha Atma, Nahana Sushtu. Sushtu is Samyak Vijnyeha. It is Vijnyeha means Vijnyatum Shakyaha. Vijnyeha is Vijnyatum Shakyaha. Shakya is capable, capability, capable to understand. Na Vijnyatum Shakyaha cannot be clearly understood. Sushtu, well. Sushtu is well. That Suvijnyeha, that Su stands for Sushtu. Samyak. Samyak Vijnyeha. Well, clear understanding. Na Suvijnyeha. Therefore, no clear understanding is possible when taught by such teacher. Na Nahi Sushtu Samyak Vijnyeha Vijnyatum Shakyaha. Up to that, we have to stop. Then the next line starts. Why? The reason is given. Yes, mat. Bhagudha asti nasti.
Bhagudha asti nasti.
Karta akarta. Shuddha ashuddha.
Shuddha ashuddha.
Iti anekadha.
Iti anekadha.
Chintyamanaha vadivihi.
Chintyamanaha vadivihi.
Okay. Why cannot be understood when taught by such teacher? Avarena manushyena proktaha yeshaha atma nasu vijnyaha vijnyatum shakyaha. Katam? Why? Yasmat. Because Yasmat is the reason is given. Yasmat. Because Bhagudha. Bhagudha means different manifold ways. Atma is Bhagudha Chintyamanaha. The Moolam is Bhagudha Chintyamanaha. Atma is imagined, it is speculated in many ways. Manifold ways. What are those manifold ways? Asti. One set of people say Atma Asti. Other set of people say Atma Nasti. That is what Nachiketa also asked Yamadharma Raja. If you remember the first chapter, 20th mantra. Asti iti eke vadanti, nasti iti cha eke vadanti. Nachiketa asked Yamadharma Raja, that the third boon, 20th mantra of the first chapter, when he asked about Atma, he presented Atma like this. Some people say Atma is there, some say Atma is not there. So therefore, here also the same thing. Asti nasti. Different ways of speculation. Atma is asti, Atma nasti. Atma karta. Atma is karta. Atma is a doer. Atma is the doer. Atma is akarta. Atma nasti. Those who say Atma nasti, they are all Shunyavadis. They are Shunyavadis. And some say Atma is karta. Some say Atma is akarta. So for Nayayikas and Vaisheshika. Nayayika and Vaisheshika, for them Atma is karta. Whereas for Vedanti and Sankhya, Atma is akarta. So different darshanas, different speculations are given. And some say Atma is Shuddha. It cannot be adulterated, contaminated. It is Nitya Mukta Shuddha Subhavaha. Sarvada, always. Nitya. Some say Atma is Ashuddha. It is impure. It has to be purified. Nayayikas, for Nayayikas, Atma has got Raga, Dvesha, all the impurities. Whereas for us, Atma is Shuddha. It is not touched by anything. So therefore, Iti Anekadha. Iti Anekadha. So it is Anekadha in different ways. Chintyamanaha. Chintyamanaha by whom? Vadibihi. In different ways it is thought, it is imagined by the people who propound, who put forth the philosophies. Vadibihi. Vadibihi. Vaktum Shilam Yasya. Vadibihi. Vaktum Shilam Yasya. Vadim. That is the people, the propounder of the various philosophies, they speculate Atma to be in different ways. Bhaguda, Bhaguda Chintyamanaha Te. Okay. If that is so, if it is Atma is speculated in so many ways, in different ways, Katam Punaha Suvignyaha Yuktuchate. How can you say Atma can be easily understood? Atma is available for easy comprehension. How can you say? Because in the previous mantra, suvignyeha, the word came. In the previous mantra, Atma is available for easy comprehension. If Atma is available for so many interpretations, speculations, then how can you say Atma is suvignyeha? It can be easily comprehended. How can you say? Katam punaha. Can repeat.
Katam punaha.
Punaha.
Suvigyeyaha yuchyate.
Suvigyeyaha yuchyate.
Ananya prokte.
Ananya prokte.
Ananyena apratak darshina. Acharyena
Acharyena
Pratipadya Brahmatma Bhutena
Pratipadya Brahmatma Bhutena
Proktaha Uktaha
Proktaha
Uktaha
Atmani
Atmane
Gatihi Anekada Asti
Gatihi
Anekada Astihi
Nasti Ityadi Lakshana Chinta
Nasti Ityadi Lakshana Chinta
Gatihi Atra Asmin Atmani
Nasti
na vidyate.
Nasti na vidyate.
Sarva vikalpa gati.
Sarva vikalpa gati.
We cannot stop there, it is one word. Sarva vikalpa gati pratyastha mitatvat.
Sarva
vikalpa gati
pratyastha mitatvat atmanah.
Okay, we will see the meaning of this line. Katam punaha suvignyaha iti uchyate. How can Atma be easily comprehended if there are so many speculations? Atma is available for easy comprehension. When it is taught Ananya Prokte, when it is taught by the Uttama Acharya, Ananya Guru, Uttama Acharya, Ananya, one who sees nothing other than himself Anyahana Vidyate, the one who sees himself to be Brahma. He looks upon everything is Brahma for him. Therefore, Ananyena Apratak Darshina. He doesn't have a different vision. He doesn't see anything as different from himself. Apratak Darshina. Pratak Darshinam Darshanam Nasti. He is not a Pratak Darshina. Pratak Darshina is the one who sees who has the subject-object division. Who can see the subject-object division? For him, everything is Atma. Everything is Brahma. Therefore, there is no separation. There is no Pratak. There is no separation. Therefore, Apratak. He doesn't look upon himself as separate from Brahma. He is one with Brahma. That is Apratak Darshina. By that person, Ananyena, Acharyena, Ananya Acharyena, Uttama Guru. Uttama Guruna, when taught by such person, Pratipadya, when revealed, Pratipadya Brahmatma Bhutena. When taught, Pratipadya, when revealed, Brahmatma Bhuta. Brahmatma Bhuta is not different, is Atma, is Brahma. So, is not different from Brahma. Brahmatma Bhuta. Brahmatma is Brahma. Brahma cha, also Atma cha, is the one who is Brahmatma, not different from Brahma. He has that vision. When revealed by such person, Pratipadya Brahmatma Bhutena Ananyena Acharyena Proktaha taught Uktaha. Proktaha is equal to Uktaha. Prakarshena Uktaha. When well taught by such person, well taught by such person, Atmani. So here Ananya Prokta is, the meaning is taken to be the Uttama Acharya. That is the meaning. I told in the beginning itself, before the Vashyam. So that meaning is taken here. So when taught by such Acharya, then Atmani Gatihi Anekada Asti Nasti Ityadi Lakshana Chinta. The word Gatihi is given the meaning here. Gatihi is equal to Anekada Asti Nasti Ityadi Lakshana Chinta. That is Gati. Gati is with regard to Atma. Asti Nasti. Is there, not there? Ityadi Lakshana. That is that thinking, that doubtful thinking. Chinta is thinking. That imagined, the doubtful thinking, which is characterized by the thoughts. Atma asti, Atma nasti. That is a gati. So, with regard to Atma, Atmani Vishaye, Gatihi, Anekada, Gatihi is equal to, the Bhashyam, Gatihi is equal to, Anekada, Asti, Nasti, Ityadi, Lakshana, Chinta. The word Gatihi is explained by Bhashyakara as, Anekada, Asti, Nasti, Ityadi, Lakshana, Chinta is Gatihi. So, with reference to the Atma, this doubtful thinking, doubtful thinking, whether Atma is there or not there, a doubtful thinking which is characterized by the presence of Atma and absence of Atma, that is the Gatihi. Atra asmin atmani vishaye nasti na vidyate. It will not be there when taught by such teacher, Uttama Guru, Ananyena Acharyena Proktaha. When Atma is revealed by such teacher, then this gati, the doubtful thinking, this doubt, the samshaya jnanam with regard to Atma, Atmani vishaye nasti na vidyate. It will not be there. Na vidyate, it is not present. It is not present. Why? Sarva vikalpa gati pratyastamitatvat atmanaha. Because sarva, all, vikalpa gati, sarva, vikalpa gati, all differences of opinion, all difference of opinions, all the differences of opinion, pratyastamitatvat, it gets resolved in Atma. All the differences of opinion, they have the resolution, they get resolved in the Atma when it is taught by the person, the competent teacher, who has the clear vision. When it is taught, there will not be samshaya jnanam with regard to Atma, whether Atma is there or whether it is not there, that samshaya, the samshaya jnanam will not be there. Therefore, suvijneha, Atma is suvijneha iti uchyate. The question was, katam punaha suvijneha iti uchyate, ananya prokte, Atma suvijneha iti uchyate. Question is asked and it is answered by the Vibhashyakara. When taught by such people, all the differences of opinion with regard to Atma gets resolved in Atma. That is the meaning. Continuing the next line of the Bhashyam. Now, Bhashyakara gives different meaning for the word Ananya Prokte as well as Atihi, about which we saw in the beginning itself, before the Bhashyam. Then, Atava. Can repeat.
Athava
Swatma Bhute
Swatma Bhute
Ananyasmin Atmani
Ananyasmin Atmani
Prokte Ananya Prokte
Ananya Prokte Ananya Prokte
Gatihi
Gatihi
Atra Anya Avagatihi Nasti
Atra Anya Avagatihi Nasti.
I hope you can follow. I've split the Sandhi.
Yes, sir.
Atra Anya Avagatihi Nasti Nyeyasya Anyasya Abhavat
Nyeyasya Anyasya Abhavat.
Okay, you will see this line. Atava Svatma Bhute Ananyasmin Atmani Prokte Ananya Prokte Gatihi Atra Anya Gatihi Nasti Nyayasya Anyasya Abhavat. Atava. Atava is Atava or Svatma Bhute Ananyasmin Ananya Asmin Atmani Ananyasmin Atmani Prokte. Ananyasmin is what? Advaita. Advaita Atma. When this non-dual Atma, Advaita Atma, which is not different from Svatma Bhuta, which is not different from oneself. Svatma Bhuta. Svatma Bhuta Atma. Svatma Bhuta oneself. It is not different from Atma. When this non-dual Atma, Advaita Atma, which is not different from oneself, na anyaha, ananyasmi atmani prokte. When this Atma, which is not different from me, aham brahma asmi, when this Atma is prokte, that is ananya prokte. Ananya prokte is when Advaita Atma, when non-dual Atma is taught, Ananya Prokte, in that case, Gatihi is equal to Atra, with regard to this Vishaya, with regard to this Atmani Vishaya, Anya Avagatihi Nasti. Here the word Gatihi is taken as Anya Avagatihi. There is no Anya, another, second, Avagatihi, understanding. There is no second understanding. It means there is no second thing to be known. Nyeyasya anyasya abhavat. abhavat, absence. Because of the absence of the second thing to be known, because of the absence of second to be thing to be known, there is no second thing available for your comprehension. There is no anya avagatiki nasti. Second thing, second comprehension, that is another comprehension, different comprehension, anya avagatihi is not possible. Why? Because nyayasya anyasya abhavat. Because of the absence of the another thing to be known. It means what? Nischaya jnanam bhavati ityartha. I hope you understand this line. Atra anya avagatihi nasti. Here there is no other thing to be known, because Atma being Advaita, what is the second thing to be known? It is not there. Abhavat. To be known is not there. To be another thing to be known is not there. Because of that, this Advaita Atma can be easily understood. Suvijnayaha. This is one meaning you can take. Previous meaning we saw, this is another meaning. Now, the next line. Jnanasya hesha paranishta. Yada paranishta only. Paranishta. Yada atmaikatva vijnanam. Yada atmaikatva vijnanam.
Yada
atmaikatva vijnanam.
Atmaikatva
vijnanam. Okay. Ataha. Avagantavya. Avagantavya abhavat.
Avagantavya abhavat.
Na gatihi atra avashishyate.
Na gatihi atra avashishyate.
Okay, this line we will see. Jnanasya hi hesha paranishta yad atmaikatva vijnanam. Okay, not yada atmaikatva vijnanam. When I split that wrongly. Yad atmaikatva vijnanam. Okay. Jnanasya hi hesha paranishta yad atmaikatva vijnanam taha avagantavya abhavat na katihi atra avashishyate. Okay, so jnanasya, what jnanasya? Atmanaha jnanasya paranishta yat atma ekatva vijnanam. Ekatva vijnanam, the knowledge of oneness. The Atma and Brahma being not different, they are one. I am not different from Jagat Karanam Brahma, that knowledge, that Advaita Ekatva Vijnanam, it Ekatva Vijnanam. It is what? It is the Paranishta. Nishta is Paranishta. It is the culmination. Nishta is the pursuit. It is the Paranishta. It's the culmination of all the. It's a culmination of the pursuit. It's a culmination of the pursuit of jnanasya, of the knowledge. Jnanasya, for the jnanam, what is the nishta? What is the culmination? Paranishta, what is the? Paranishta is the culmination of the pursuit of jnanam. Culmination of the pursuit of this jnana, jnana marga, this shayas, what is that culmination? Atmaikatva vijnanam, the oneness of the Atma and Brahma. Atma ekatva vijnanam. What is there is only Atma only. Ekatvam. Ekatvam is oneness. What is there is only one. Brahman alone is there. There is no second thing to Brahma. So, the culmination of this knowledge ends with the knowledge of the understanding of Atma being one. That is the meaning. Therefore, ataha, avagantavya abhavat na gatihi atra avashishyate. Avagantavya abhavat. Therefore, avagantavya, to be known, abhavat. There is no second thing to be known. Avagantavya abhavat. So there is avagantavya, to be understood, abhavat, absence. Because of the absence of to be understood, what absence? A second thing. Second thing is not that to Brahma, because ekatva vijnanat anantaram, after having understood that everything is Brahma, there is only Brahma, therefore nothing to be known further. There is no second thing to be known. Avagantavya abhavat atra na gatihi. Atra na gatihi. Atra avashishyate. No gatihi is left out. What is gatihi? Yes, no doubt. No doubt, no samshaya jnanam is left after gaining this knowledge. Atmaikatva vijnanam. After getting that vijnanam, when that nishta, when nishta happens in ekatva, atma ekatva vijnanam, when that nishta happens because of the knowledge gained from the teacher, who is a uttama guru, ananya guru, after gaining jnanam from such teacher, or having understood the Atma, because Atma is Advaita Atma. Therefore, having got the jnanam of Advaita Atma, since there is no second thing to be known, therefore, atra, atasmin vishaye, with regard to this, there is no possibility of confusion. Gatihi can mean samshaya jnanam, confused knowledge. It's not possible. Confused knowledge or erroneous knowledge, viparita jnanam or samshaya jnanam, atra na avashishyate, it is not avashishyate, doesn't remain. No confusions remain. Therefore, it is suvijnyeha. Continuing the second line, the next line, samsara gatihi va atra.
Samsara gativa atra.
Nasti.
Nasti.
Ananya atmani.
Ananya atmani.
Prokte.
Prokte.
Na antariya katvat.
Na antariya katvat.
Tad vijnana phalasya mokshasya.
Tad vijnana phalasya mokshasya.
Okay, here another meaning is given. You will see. Can mute now. Samsara gati hiva. Atra nasti ananya atmani prokte na antariya katvat vijnana phalasya mokshasya. Samsara gati hiva. Va means or, another meaning is given. Another meaning is given for the word gati. Gatihi, previously we saw gati can mean erroneous knowledge, confused knowledge, samshaya jnanam. But here another meaning is given for the word. Gatihi, samsara gatihi va. So samsara gatihi, samsara gati, gati means the destination. Gati means destination. Samsara gati is the travel. A destination to be attained in the samsara. Because in samsara, for everything we have a destination. There is a goal to be reached. A destination is there. So, samsara gatihi atra nasti. Like samsara as a gati. So, here samsara gati is not there. With regard to this, atra asmin vishaye, asmin atmani vishaye, samsara gatiki nasti. There is no gati. There is no destination. Destination is not there means what? There is no travel. Samsara gati. There is no travel in the samsara, inside the samsara, for the person who has gained this jnanam. Samsara gatiki va atra nasti. When taught by the ananya guru, or when understanding the atma to be the advaita atma, for that person, samsara gatihi, the travel in the samsara, inside the samsara, not there. So that meaning also we can take. The word gatihi can mean samsara gatihi, a travel in the samsara. Na asti, nasti. It's not there for that person. It's not there. Why? Because when Advaita Jnanam takes place, and when this Advaita Atma is revealed as oneself. Ananya, Ananya Atmani Prokte. Ananya Advaita Atmani Prokte. When this Advaita Atma is taught, what is the result of that? When this Advaita Atma is taught, Moksha. Moksha is the result. Moksha, when Advaita Atma is known, Advaita, knowing when the Advaita Atma, the knowledge of the Advaita Atma is gained, Atma being you, and when that is gained, you are Brahma. That when that knowledge is gained, what is the result? Moksha. So, Jnanapalasya, Asya, Jnanapalasya, Mokshasya. So, Moksha is the Jnanapalam. Jnanapalam is Moksha. Advaita Jnanam gives the Moksha, gives the Jnanapalam, Moksha. Therefore, gaining this Jnanam, gaining the Advaita Jnanam is gaining Moksha, gaining Muktihi. So what is the gap between these two, gaining Jnanam and gaining Mukti? There is no gap, there is no interval. Therefore, Na Antariya Katvat Tad Vijnana Palasya Mokshasya Antariya. Antariya katvat. It means there is no difference, there is no gap, there is no gap between gaining this jnanam and gaining moksha. Gaining advaita jnanam is gaining moksha. Therefore, when you gain this advaita jnanam, samsara gatihi nasti. When the knowledge of atma, advaita atma is gained, there is no samsara gati. There is no samsara for that person. Why? Because the person, he gets mukti, he gets moksha. Because he has gained jnanam. Gaining jnanam is not different from gaining moksha. Therefore, no samsara gati for that person. That is the meaning. Then, Acharya didn't stop here. He continues. He is going to give another meanings. Yeah, two more meanings will come. Meanings for the word gati. That we will see. We will see the next class. So next class we will start from Atava. So we will not spend much time in introducing this mantra again. So hope you understand after this. So we will stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om
Dhanyavadah.
Dhanyavadah. Dhanyavadah. Dhanyavadah.
Dhanyavadah.